back in Beresford, my dad was the high school wrestling coach for many years. My sister, Brooke, and I both always wanted to wrestle, so we'd always go up in the wrestling room with our dad and wrestle.
She was raised that way, and you can see a lot of her toughness come from some of that early education. And so there are a lot of kind of interesting things about Cori that a lot of people don't know.
Kindergarten I started, and I wrestled up until, I think, seventh grade.
It was around that time that she turned her focus to soccer.
I went to Vermilion High School and asked them if I could play soccer for them because it's an unorganized sport there. It's not run by the school, and they said I could. So I started playing in seventh grade for Vermilion.
Really saw a spark, something that was kind of electrifying, so to speak, from her when she was on the field, and started recruiting her, and glad that she's at South Dakota State.
Milk certainly does a body good, but it also helped Bonte in other ways. She earned the Milk Mustache Scholarship from the U.S. Dairy Association.
So as a child, I was on growth hormone, and they always preached to me that I needed to drink more milk. And we won free trip to Florida, my family and I, and then I got some scholarship money with that as well. They had a mixture of the milk, and we had to drink it and have the mustache on our lip and do an interview like that.
Bonte was a freshman on SDSU's Summit League Championship team that advanced to the second round of the NCAA tournament in 2008.
Cori gave us a different dynamic, even as a freshman, to come in and change the game, and she was a big reason we made such a great run in 2008.
I didn't really expect to see much playing time, but as the season went on, I saw more and more, and you know, I guess it was really just playing for those seniors for me. My first year, I wanted to do everything I could for them because I knew it was their last year and their last opportunity to have a chance at the NCAAs.
Last year, Bonte's season was cut short due to a knee injury.
It was very frustrating. I was hoping that I hadn't played enough games yet so I could get an injury redshirt, but I was over the amount. But it was a quick recovery, and I came back in the spring a little nervous to do some of the things, but you know, Lang had talked to me about how his injuries, and the main thing is coming back as strong as you can and not being worried about re-injuring that same thing.
She wants to play and be in the game all the time. It was tough, certainly from a psychological standpoint, but from a physical standpoint, she worked very hard to get herself back in, and it was almost like you never knew anything had happened.
As a senior, Bonte has had to step up into more of a leadership role.
She's a captain of the team. She's the go-to person. She has a great relationship with the players on the team. They respect her. Her work ethic is tremendous. And so, but she's a quiet leader, and she doesn't cheerlead on the field, so to speak, but when she talks, people listen.
I just want the younger girls to be able to look up to me, see me as a role model, and I want to be able to set that leadership example for them so that when our senior class leaves, they still have those people that can fill those roles.
And as far as her future is concerned, Bonte says she is keeping her options open.
I'm actually looking into grad school. I think I'm gonna stay here around this area and go to grad school. I've already talked to Lang about possibly sticking around and helping out with the soccer team. But after that, you know, I'm looking to maybe be a physical education and health teacher, also a coach of either soccer or basketball.